on, everyone, and happy holidays to you. Today we're discussing Once Upon a Deadpool. Once Upon a Deadpool, well, this is a PG-13 version and a PG-13 cut of Deadpool 2. A film that I like. I think the original Deadpool is perfect. It's one of my favorite films of all time. I get countless rewatches on that thing. And Deadpool 2 I do enjoy. I have a lot of issues with the story per se, but the action's great. There's still a lot of great humor in there. But this is a PG-13 version of Deadpool. I know they're trying to do the fudge cancer, and a lot of the profits are going to cancer research. So if you're a fan of Deadpool 2, why not give it a shot? And it's PG-13, so more families and people who are kind of restricted from seeing rated R films can now check this version out for themselves, which is nice to see that more people are going to be able to see Ryan Reynolds' version of Deadpool. The version from X-Men Origins Wolverine, we're never going to talk about that. But this is kind of just a middle-of-the-road thing. The Fred Savage stuff that we do see in the trailers that I kind of stayed away from, I saw like little glimpses of it, but I wanted to stay away, and I'm glad I did, because I wonder how much they actually showed in the trailers of his scenes, because there's not a lot of him in here. There's some good glimpses of him and some moments that really made me laugh and really made it worthwhile, but a PG-13 version of Deadpool, it's nice to see that, like, it restricted, obviously, the blood, it restricted the curse words, the sexual stuff, and they do make it work. Like, I won't lie that this film did not work. It did work for what it was, but the fact that I know that there is a Deadpool that is rated R, and it's the same exact version, but funnier, you just take out the Fred Savage stuff, it worked for me. And I would rather just rewatch Deadpool 2 again. And I own it. But Once Upon a Dime Deadpool, or Once Upon a Deadpool, whatever the hell they're calling it, it's fine. It's serviceable. If you're a big, massive Deadpool fan, I think you'll enjoy it. If you're a big Princess Bride fan, throw that in there too. And if you're someone who's never seen Deadpool, and for some reason you can't watch it because you're not of the age yet, or maybe your family won't let you watch a rated R film yet, Once Upon a Dime Deadpool, or whatever the hell it's called, that it's there for you. You're gonna laugh, you're gonna enjoy it, but if you've already seen Deadpool 2, I can't really recommend it to you unless you really, really love that film. The Princess Bride stuff's cool, the Fred Savage stuff's cool, but eventually it's probably just gonna go on YouTube or on another cut of Deadpool 2, or it'll show up somewhere for you to watch. Again, some great jokes in there. Everything's pretty much the same. They took out the blood, they cut up some of the action scenes, but one thing that did bother me a lot, and I wish they wouldn't have done this, is I understand that you have to get around some of the language barriers to make the movie move faster. It's at a faster pace now, but there's a couple sequences when I was like, yeah, I understand you're wearing a mask, and in ADR you can switch what you're saying, but I can totally tell that your mouth is not moving as fast as you are talking. And it really bothered me because it just didn't add up. And I think that was a very slight issue. There's a couple continuity errors too. I know I'm like being really nitpicky, but if you're going to go for the PG-13 cut, don't half-ass it. And I feel like sometimes this was a little bit half-assed. I get it. It's for cancer. That's awesome. I'm glad a lot of the proceeds are going for it. I'm really happy a lot of people are going to be able to enjoy a PG-13 version of Deadpool and be introduced to this Ryan Reynolds character. But again, I have the rated R version. I'd rather just watch the original version. But I will say, I still get emotional with Vanessa and Wade in here. Before I get to my final thoughts, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button if you guys enjoyed this review. You guys can check out some other reviews I also do on this channel down below. And plus, check out Sandwich on Films, because right down there you guys can get into advanced movie screens. You can check out some movie news and even some movie reviews. But, of course, for my final thoughts, I enjoyed it. It's fine. It's serviceable. The Fred Savage stuff is the highlight of the film. I mean, that's the one thing that was a really big highlight. I wish they would have done more with this. I think this could have been a very intriguing concept. Maybe they're just testing the waters for what they can do with the character when it does go over to Disney. I hope Disney does not do that. I think they still will keep it rated R and just put it under a different studio that they own. I guess time will tell. Still a fun time at the movie, so if you didn't get to see Deadpool 2, maybe you should check out this version instead, then go check out and buy the original version. So with all that said, I'm going to give Once Upon a Deadpool a C+. What are your guys' thoughts are on this? Are you guys interested in? Are you not? Let's talk about it down below. Do you like Deadpool 1 or Deadpool 2 better? Again, let's talk about it down below. Thank you guys so much for watching this, and until next time, stay classy.